Hey everyone, welcome. My name is Marilyn Shannon and welcome to the Breaking Free show today. It's so nice to have you here. Happy holidays to everybody out there. I hope you had a wonderful weekend, time with your family, wherever you are. And I want to say hi to Amnon before we get started into the...
Hello, Marilyn. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I am just fine. Missed you last week.
What was last week?
You keep doing this to me.
I know.
I'm waiting and the window and there's no Marilyn.
Oh, isn't that nice? Well, you know, we do the show live, so, you know, Amnon and I miss each other when we're not connected each week, but it was the holiday and I had a lot of things to do. So anyway, on with the show. So many of you out there know that I have recently self-published my first of many books, and I'm so excited, and there's so much to learn, so much to understand, so much to get excited by. So we are doing a series about publishing, and I know a lot of you out there have a book at the tip of your tongue or a book at the tip of your heart, and you want very much to express yourself. And I know today is that opportunity, because we all have the opportunity to do anything we want to do, especially when we have the information to do it. And I want to give that information to you. So I have two experts in the field who are going to help you today and me, because there's always more to learn about how to be the best that we can be and how we can take the power to publish our own books. So I want to welcome today Marilyn Hill. Welcome. And Sherry Wilkolowski to our show. How are you both doing?
Great.
I'm doing great. Thank you, Marilyn.
Good. It's nice to have you both here.
It's great to be here.
Good. So first, Marilyn, and we're probably going to get stumbled on your name because it's my name. So Marilyn, first tell us who Marilyn Hill is.
Well, Marilyn Hill's a woman who's had many careers, mildly. But I started, I did marketing copy and advertising copy for many years. I wrote incentive programs, but a friend of mine, Brenda Hill, who we just happened to marry men with the same last name after we had been friends for years, she said to me at one point, she said, we need to write a book together. Let's write a book. And in 2001, we published our first book. And we got into writing it by accident. We had always written, I had written ad copy and business copy, marketing copy. But writing a book was different. And that we got into it, in a sense, by accident. And have been writing a lot since, continually since then, and helping authors and helping ourselves and enjoying life. We were at a different stage in our life when we started.
Hmm. Well, I want to get to Sherry in a minute, but before we do, what was that book called?
Our first book was Our Love Affairs with Food and Travel.
Okay.
The second book was with a French master chef, and it was Cooking Secrets, the Why and How. And our third book, a chef, Bill Waverin, had said to us, why don't you write a book on how to write a book. So our third book was Success with Writing, Your Path to a Successful Book. And it talked about how to write a book.
Okay, good. Yeah. Well, give us some,
Yeah, it doesn't compare to what Sherry's book covers on in publishing Architect, because at the time, our book was, someone referred to it, oh, this is a Bible on how to write a book. But, and it is, but it doesn't compare to all the aspects that Publishing Architect does, because Publishing Architect goes into much more detail and covers many more aspects than we could begin to cover, because I knew a lot, but every day there's so much more.
Right.
And that's her expertise. And so it's just such a wonderful industry, and there's so many opportunities that are there that it brings out. But we'll get on to that.
Yeah, yes. No, I agree with you. It's kind of, you know, when you think of the name of the show, Breaking Free, we like talking about the things that we all can do, that we can do independently and don't, you know, have to rely on somebody else and, you know, to do for us, that we actually have the power to understand these things ourselves. So I wanna get into this really deeply. So, Sherry, tell everybody who Sherry is and about your book.
Yeah, I'm Sherry Wilkolaski. I'm a publishing architect, and I specialize in independent publishing and self-publishing. And I published my first book back in 2003, and it became a bestseller. And it was self-published. I published through Lulu.com, which is a competitor of CreateSpace, which is Amazon's self-publishing division. And I've been working with authors ever since. So coming up on just about 16,000 authors I've worked with and hundreds of small to mid-sized publishers. And I'm also editor-in-chief of LuxBeat magazine.
And LuxBeat is what? Tell everybody that.
LuxBeat magazine is a luxury lifestyle publication, LuxBeatMag.com. And Marilyn Hill is our executive editor, and we co-founded the publication back in 2013.
So let's get into it. Okay, so the first place to start, so we're going to be talking about alternative to, you know, in publishing, self-publishing, independent, indie publishing, all of those kinds of things, so we all understand how we decipher what the differences are. So which one of you would like to start? Marilyn?
Yeah, I'll go. Start. Because when I started my first book with a friend, and I did co-authored the three books I wrote. I would say I was the grunt work person, though, and I did a lot of research. We did have a traditional publisher who was willing to publish our first book, but it was going to take 2 years, and we didn't want to wait 2 years. We were so anxious, and I had already researched print on demand, and we had promised, which you should never do, but we had promised the chefs that our book would be out by Christmas, and we had included over 100 chefs from 19 different countries, and we wanted to come through with our promise. And we had already checked out, I had checked out, that even if we use this traditional publisher, we were going to still have to market our own book, and we were still going to have to do all of these things ourselves that a traditional publisher doesn't do. They only market you for 28 days, and that's if you're lucky. And so, and we'd still have to wait 2 years, and we weren't willing to do that. And it was a small house. I can't say I was being picked up by some other big house. Big house, I would have waited 2 years probably. But
did you say you would have waited 2 years, or you wouldn't have?
No, I probably would have. If it would have been one of the big four, I would have undoubtedly waited.
Okay, but it still would have taken 2 years.
It would have taken at least two, and then they could have cut it. You never know on that, but my ego would have undoubtedly been such that I don't know, but I think I probably would have been overwhelmed if a big house had said, well, we're going to pick you up and here's an advance. I don't know if I could have turned that down, but it was a small house and we chose to self-publish, and I had done all the research on the self-publishing companies at that time, and I found self-publishing was the way to go. And we continued on and did two more books and found it very lucrative. Now, and it's not only that books aren't going to sell unless you market them. And one of the things that you do with self-publishing and what Publishing Architect shows you is what you need to do all the way, every step of the way, so that you can market your book correctly and that you take all of these steps necessary in publishing, because it's every step of the way you should be doing things that you need to do or have someone else help you with it. Mm-hmm. And there's just all these little nooks and crannies, and that was why having someone reading about it, you can learn what to do yourself. And I've helped many authors. Sherry's helped hundreds and hundreds, probably thousands more. Whereas I've helped, mine are probably in the couple hundreds. But there's so much that can be done as you go along. And when you've got a workbook that you can use as a workbook reference, that helps tremendously. But one of the things I did when I was president of the International Food, Wine, and Travel Writers Association was I got people to speak at our conventions and or conferences. And Sherry was one of the speakers that I rounded up. That's how I met her. We had phone conversations ahead of time. And I said, would you like to speak at our conference? And she was such a dynamic speaker that that's how our friendship started to evolve. And it's been a learning experience on both of our parts ever since. And she went on, she spoke in Beijing on print-on-demand publishing. And
well, Marilyn, let me just interrupt you a second. I don't want to get too far away from some of the things that you said that I would like to expand on. So okay. You said that it's lucrative and that there's a lot of things that you can do. That's compared to going the traditional route, right?
Right.
And so with traditional houses, they will only market for you for 30 days, 28 days. What did you say, 28 days?
28 days if you're lucky.
If you're lucky, regardless, unless, of course, it becomes a number one bestseller in 28 days on the New York Times bestsellers list. Am I understanding that?
Oh, no.
Okay.
You can be a New York Times bestseller, and they still only market you for 28 days. When you are a book, for instance, I can give you a book that's been on the bestseller list for 20 years, 30 years, Atlas Shrugged. They meet with the publisher once a month to do planning, but they pay for that. They pay for their in-store promotions. It is not the publisher that pays.
Okay.
So you need to be prepared. James Patterson plans his own marketing. The publisher does not pay for all of that marketing.
Okay.
Market 28 days.
Okay, so they pay for the first 28 days, and then after that, you're on your own.
That's right.
So after the first 28 days, are there any perks of being in a big, traditional, small traditional house?
I think Sherry probably could answer that question better than I could, but I don't really think so, other than the name recognition.
Okay.
And name recognition means a lot. It does mean a lot. It gets you, you are on the same lists for different bookstores, but it does matter, but not if you have your own, if you know how to market or you hire someone to market your books. They can do as good a job. But for some people, the snob recognition of a big house does make a difference. But Sherry, I think you can speak to that.
Okay. All right, you want to step in and show your book too?
Yeah, I'll be happy to show my book. Here's my book, Publishing Architect's Blueprint, Self-Publishing Fundamentals. But to expand on what Marilyn was saying, yes, there is a benefit to being traditionally published and having that name recognition. I'll just use romance, the romance genre. I mean, if you're published by Harlequin, you know, that's fantastic. Your title will be bundled in and marketed with the other books in their catalog, which is fantastic. So your book is positioned against other best-selling titles. It's easy for discovery. So those readers who particularly like the authors that Harlequin, for example, is publishing, they may be more inclined to find your book. But you, at the end of the day, you need to look at the contract and the agreement and see what is that publisher actually offering? How much are you going to make up front? And run the numbers and see, okay, is there the benefit, if I'm going to be investing in my marketing anyway as a traditionally published author, just as you would if you self-publish, what type of royalty, what is that percentage of the sale that you're ultimately going to receive at the end of the day? So you really have to run the numbers and see what the benefits and do a pros and cons list But more likely than not, self-publishing, you've got more control over the long term, and financially, you're going to be investing in marketing either which way. So, you know, personally, I say, unless you've got a, you know, six-figure contract, you might as well do it yourself.
And so what is the difference, let's say, between an indie and self-publishing?
The term crosses over. Independent publishing is self-publishing. There are small independent publishing houses. I have a small independent press based out of Charleston, Presque Publishing, and we've published, we've got a trilogy, it's a thriller trilogy that we've got, paranormal thriller. First two books are out. And really that just means, you know, we have paid the authors a small amount of money up front in advance, and then we split the royalty with the authors on the book sales. As well as, we do have a film coming out that goes along with the book series. And so we'll be split, you know, there will be a small advance on that as well, and we will share that with the authors. But really, independent publishing, you know, can mean you're doing self-publishing, or it is a small press that should be paying for the basic fundamentals of publishing the book. So that would mean the formatting of the book, the editing of the content, creating the book cover design, investing in the ISBN number, the barcode, the small barcode that you see on the back of the book. There's a fee for that, for paying for the copyright submission and things like that. There are some fundamental expenses that go into publishing a book. So an independent publisher should be giving you an advance, and they should be covering those fees. If you find, as you're looking and searching and trying to find a place to actually self-publish your book, and you stumble upon a small publishing house that says they're an indie publisher, but they would like to charge you, then they are not an actual independent press. They are a self-publishing house.
So there's a difference.
There is a difference.
So what do you? We have the big houses. We have the indie, and we have self-publishing.
Correct.
So, what do you suggest that people do? I'm writing a book. Mm-hmm. Is it a good idea to self-publish first, to build up some momentum and then try to take it someplace, or do I just stick to the route of self-publishing?
Well, in this market, there's two paths. So in your case, you've self-published your first book.
Right.
You know, we work together on that. We've got it out to the world. It's in all the distribution channels, Amazon, Barnes & Noble, et cetera, IndieBound and whatnot. You've paid up front for all, you've paid all the expenses, and you're keeping 100% of the royalties. So you're using your book as a speaker. You're using it to get out there to promote your online TV show and your radio program, and, you know, you're out there building your business and picking up new clients, and that's fantastic. Down the road, depending on how many copies you sell and depending on how you continue to grow your business, you may be approached by a traditional house or a small independent press, and they say, hey, Marilyn, we'd like to make you an offer. And at the end of the day, you need to look at the numbers and say, does it really make sense? You've put all this work into it. You know, how much money are they going to pay you, and what is the long-term benefit of doing so? Now, there are a lot of authors who are self-publishing. You can self-publish through CreateSpace, or even if you don't, you know, Amazon is watching to see what books are selling that are independently and self-published. And they are making offers to those authors who are selling, you know, between 10 and 15,000 copies a year, because there is something to be said, you know, for sales at that level, where they can then take it and push it a little bit further. They may have wider distribution and things like that, and they can bundle it in with the books that they're already selling. Particularly Amazon can market it all they want on Amazon.com. So, It really depends. You can go down either road. But I would say, at the end of the day, it all comes down to the numbers and what you really want to do long term with that title.
So let's talk, let's explain what CreateSpace is.
Okay. CreateSpace, CreateSpace.com, is Amazon's self-publishing division. So this is a place where an author can go and self-publish It's an online publishing platform, and you basically go online, you upload the interior files of your book. So you've got your PDF file of the interior of the manuscript. You've got your book cover file that you upload. You can also, they've got an online wizard, so you can create your cover, doing a photograph on the cover, on the back, on the front, you know, dropping in your book synopsis and whatnot. And they will provide you with an ISBN number if you want to do it for free, or you can purchase your own, either which way. And that book, once you hit publish, will get out there to the world, get out to Amazon. You can also distribute in other channels to libraries and other third-party bookstores and distributors and whatnot. The caveat is that if you publish with CreateSpace, and you self-publish with CreateSpace, there is no bookstore return policy on that content. So what does that mean? Bookstores and brick-and-mortar retailers require that you have a return policy. So a book is a product. Just like if you go to Best Buy and you buy a computer and you got a 30-day return policy, it doesn't work, you can bring it back. Whatever that return policy might be, it's also required for books. So you do need to have a distributor that will actually provide that. And we've got CreateSpace, and then I also recommend using Ingram Spark. So Ingram does offer that return policy. So as a self-publishing author, your book can stand up next to those other books published by the larger traditional houses, because you'll have that distribution and the return policy.
Yeah, you know, I'm promoting my book a lot. I'm going into, you know, as many places as I can go and, you know, planning my time as well as I can. And I did call somebody and they did look it up, in the moment. And they said, oh, Ingram Spark, okay.
Yeah.
And it gave me some more credibility, I think. So not everybody does that.
No, not everyone does.
Why not?
Well, I think, number one, I don't think that authors really comprehend that early in the game the importance and the value of the return policy. And just like that, they think, oh, I'm going to run into the local bookshop and see if I can do a book signing and do an event. And then they're like, oh, you can't because you've published with CreateSpace only and there's no return policy. And then they don't know where to go, and they don't know how to actually, kind of manipulate and move through the channels to get there. But Ingram Spark is a means to do so, and I do recommend using both distributors to get your book out to the world.
So Ingram is not, they don't publish. Do they get the book from CreateSpace,
or
do they?
No, you need it. You'll need to establish a separate account. Okay. So you'll have an account with CreateSpace, and you want to distribute only to Amazon. And then you want to set up an account with Ingram Spark and distribute everywhere else.
So the file has to be loaded to Ingram Spark, too.
Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
So is that all in your book?
It's all in my book, step by step.
Okay. So and just give us a little caveat again of what's in the book, just so everybody knows. So we're going to get into some more detail, but I want everybody to know, like, so the areas that you touch upon in your book are what?
Sure. I cover everything A to Z on how to self-publish. So if you want to learn the behind the scenes and get to know more about the ISBN number and distribution and all those types of things, all that data is in the book. I try to use stories to get the information out there. It is, for me, I love everything about publishing, so it's very exciting. For someone who's self-publishing a book, they may not be as inclined or interested to learn all those things, but it is important to know. But even if you just want to cut to the chase, I have several different publishing plans. So I've got different blueprints where you can follow. So whether you want to publish for free, you want to, go all out and, invest a lot of money and pay somebody to do all the work, or you want to go middle of the road and just do it as cost effectively as possible, I have a roadmap and a blueprint, and you can just go through step by step and follow it every step of the way.
And somebody can work with you as well?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
And what does that look like?
Well, it depends on what the author wants to do. I mean, I prefer, number one, that authors invest in getting and having a marketing or a publishing consultation, because many times they think they want to go down one road, and as it turns out, it might be better for them to go another route. So, for example, I have a lot of authors that I meet when I'm out speaking or networking, and they say, well, I want to wait for a traditional publisher to pick me up. Well, like Marilyn was saying, that could take several years to accomplish. And, you know, depending on, I've got an author who who's a friend of mine, and he just, he does a radio show in England, and he just won, he was the radio talk show host of the year in the UK, and he's got a new book coming out, which talks about his journey, you know, as a radio talk show host. Well, I said, Alan, this is the best time for you to get your book out now. You just had this award that you were, that came out, you got December of 2016. Let's get your book out. Now he's waiting on, he's waiting to hear from a traditional publisher, but again, that might take him 2 years. So he's gonna be making some decisions in the next few weeks. So I think, you know, everyone's publishing path is different. And so if you just pick up the book, you can, you know, contact me for a consultation, or pick up the book and I'll walk you through the process. And then at that point you can say, okay, I do want to speak with someone, but the book is designed to actually, you know, help anyone at any stage of the process.
And it'll be on Amazon.
Yes.
Not there yet.
It is on Amazon.
It is on.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So
absolutely.
They can go get it.
They can go to get it today.
All right. There you go.
Yeah.
Because I contracted with Sherry to help me, which I would highly recommend because I am busy and I don't understand everything. And nor was her book ready then. But I don't. But I rather get the help. So I paid for that. Everybody's different, but it made a big difference for me. And when I actually recently went somewhere to show them my book, they looked at the book and they said, oh, wow, this was done well. I'm like, can you just put my book up for a second? So, and that makes a big difference to me because I didn't know that. So even, you know, and that made, a, you know, it makes, because I put a lot into it, and I know you're going to put a lot into yours as well. So mine is on Amazon, too. I did publish on CreateSpace and all that good stuff. We're going to get into more, but Marilyn's going to be going in just a few moments. So before she does, Marilyn, you've been listening. I know. So fill us in on any more good stuff that you have, good tricks of the trade, before you leave us.
Okay, well, I just want to reiterate something that you just said about the book being done well is something you notice. I do a lot of book reviews, and or someone will show me their book, and sometimes you can tell when a book has not been done well. You'll notice the formatting. You'll notice the lack of editing. Someone will feel that because somebody was their English teacher or a good friend was an English teacher, that that's good enough. It isn't. I just sent Sherry an update of an article that I read that talked about the new AP guidelines that were coming out, new Chicago guidelines that are coming out that haven't been updated since 2010. And we have to keep up with all of those things. When you read something to review it or edit it, you notice all those things in a book that aren't done right. And you're not reviewing it based on that. Those things just pop out at you like crazy. And so when a book is done professionally, that pops out at you too. And it doesn't it just is like, oh, wow, this is really good. Mm-hmm. And it was done professionally. Mm-hmm. And if you're going to do a book and put the time and effort into it, you need to have it edited professionally. And you need to, if you don't want to do the marketing yourself, it's worthwhile to talk to someone and get a consultation from someone like Sherry to discuss marketing and see what opportunities there are for you to get some basic packages and understand what you can do to help market your book. Because for me personally, I ended up getting a contract for a TV show that lasted 4 years, that I made more money with the television show than I did with the book. It was great. I was earning a lot of money. So you don't know what other opportunities your book can bring to you. But it opens up all sorts of doors, and I would encourage anyone to follow their dream. But remember that you need to market your dream. It's not going to sell by itself. It's not going to be profitable just because you write it. Not every, first of all, family members are going to expect it for free. They shouldn't, but they will. And, you know, friends are going to want it for free too. You need to remember that you need to market your book for it to sell. Mm-hmm. And you need to think about that all the time you're writing it. And Sherry covers marketing and publishing Architect. But she's also writing a marketing book because it's further than even publishing an Architect has. And that's a huge part of it. And I encourage everybody to listen to the rest of the show because sure there's going to be a lot more tips.
Yes. And thank you, Marilyn. It's been so nice to meet you.
And I'm delighted you had the opportunity to meet you, too.
Yes.
Have a good show.
Thank you. And we'll see you again soon. Okay?
Okay.
Thanks. Thanks so much. Bye.
Bye.
Okay. Well, Marilyn had to leave, but we are still here talking with Sherry. And we're going to get into one question I want to ask you before we get into some other nuts and bolts. The Lulu.
Yes.
Can you just define Lulu?
So Lulu, LULU.com, is a self-publishing platform. So that is a competitor to Amazon, just Amazon's CreateSpace, and Ingram Spark. So it is another vehicle to self-publish a book. And, you know, if you want to know what is the difference between Lulu and CreateSpace, they're very similar. I would say it's a little more expensive as far as printing your book and the amount of royalty you're going to get back. But, I mean, Amazon, is, you know, CreateSpace is Amazon, so they, you know, they're ruling the world out there. So so to publish with them, publish a book is a little less expensive. But, you know, everyone's using the same printers all over, all the self, you know, print on demand. And that was kind of brought up at the top of the show. And just to clarify for the folks out there, that print on demand is a technology just allowing you to print one copy of a book at a time or as many as you might need. So, if you know that you're going to need, you know, 3,000 copies of your book, you're not going to want to do it print on demand. You're going to want to use a small press. It'll end up being less expensive, but this way, if you're using print on demand technology to self publish, that way the book is only printed at the point of sale. So, if I go online to order Marilyn's new book, and I go to Amazon and I'd like to order one copy, you know, at the point in which I place the order, pretty much that's when they go and they print it hot off the press and they ship it on out. So that way you don't have to carry any inventory.
So is there a kind of a good number for a self-published person like myself to say, well, I've sold 100 books, that's great, or I've sold 500? Is there a good number for, you know, can you generalize that way?
You know, it's tough because, you know, number one, everyone wants to recoup their initial expenses. So what did it cost you to get the book out? Mm-hmm. You know, I say, I don't like authors so much to be, especially if they're not marketing, and those authors who just, they put their book up on Amazon and just hope it's going to stick, and then they go back and they're looking every day, oh, I'm not selling. Well, what are you doing to market? And your marketing will impact the total number of books that you're selling on a regular basis, and it does take time. You also have to keep in mind, now if you self-publish with CreateSpace, you should see your numbers on Amazon. You can open up an Amazon Author Central account and you can monitor your stats and see where your sales are. If you're publishing, when you do publish through Ingram, you do get reports, but keep in mind that when you are dealing with retailers all over the world, they have to report back, so there is going to be a delay in the reporting. So don't, you know, after the first month, don't be, say, oh gosh, I've done all these events, I've done this marketing, and I don't see the results. Just know that there is going to be probably a lag time in getting that data back. But as far as total number of books, I think it's really, everyone needs to define their own level of success and how many books that you actually want to sell. You know, you should set some realistic goals. You know, if you want to say, well, I want to sell 4 million copies of my book this month, well, what are you going to do to get there? You need to have a plan. And again, you need a blueprint. I've got an outline. A third of the book, my book, Self-Publishing Fundamentals, is focused on the marketing. All the marketing basics. And when I was writing the book, Marilyn was you know, I was sending her chapters and going through, and as I was telling her, I didn't want to send her the marketing section until it was completely finished, and she was so worried I was giving too much away. And it's very comprehensive, but still, I think particularly for a new author, it will seem overwhelming, but you just have to follow it step by step. So,
yeah, you know, I have to say that I really loved working with Cherry because she really does know. And I would sit with someone telling me who, you know, I seeked out different people doing different things because I wanted to learn what other people were doing. And I remember sitting with a friend and she was saying, well, you know, she had contacted a bookstore and she couldn't get in. And then I went back to Cherry and I said, well, she can't get in. But then Cherry explained to me that I was on Ingram. And then there were so many things that, you know, seeing is learning, seeing is understanding. And unless you really tap into something and you're really working it, you don't always know. And where do you begin? I think that's really crucial when you have, I did not create a book over a weekend just to have a book. You know, it's not a 20-page thing that I just want to hand out in the doctor's office. I wanted something that had value. I spent a year putting it together. And I have others that I want to do, and I do not want them to take a year. But I'm learning from this one. And, you know, it's very exciting. And Cherry always said to me, it will change your life. And I'm like, oh, come on. What do you mean it's going to change my life? My life, you know, right? How can it change my life? Just Marilyn, just having a book. And you'd be surprised.
And here you are.
Yeah, you'd be surprised on how people look at me, plus how I walk into a room. You know, when I go in somewhere and I'm talking about marketing my book or talking to somebody about doing something, I'm going into that conversation differently. And I have more conversations I can go into now that I have my book than when I was going in as Marilyn the coach, Marilyn the talk show host, or Marilyn the speaker. There's something different going into a conversation, asking for something, doing something when you have a book.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. It extends more credibility. You know, if you think about, you know, with the magazine, so with LuxBeat magazine, we receive, you know, thousands of press releases every day for different products and for books and, you know, destinations and, you know, experts and coaches and whatnot. And, I mean, 99.9% of those press releases are tied to some sort of publication, a book, magazine, someone doing a radio or television program. I mean, but most of those folks have books, and that's what they're promoting themselves as an expert. And whether it's fiction or nonfiction, it really can make an impact on everything else you're doing.
Mm-hmm. It really does. And Chris has a question for me on the chat. And just so I can remind everybody, which I never said early on because I got so excited, I love this topic. Please feel free to call in 919-518-9773 if you have a question for Cherry, anything. This is an opportunity to talk to an expert, and you can ask enough questions. And then also you can come in at Skype at computers, that's plural, 2K voice. And also if you notice we have a chat, you can come in there and ask questions. And so Chris is asking me, what is the most important thing I learned about self-publishing? A lot of things. I think probably being, well, patience. I think patience.
Yeah?
What do you think? Is that a good one?
That is a good one. That is a good one. And I will say that she did learn that throughout
patience.
The process. Patience. Yes. I think authors need to set expectations. I mean, that's the first chapter of my book is before you even turn to the second chapter, before we start talking about publishing platforms and editing and formatting and covers, it's really, you've got to have your mind in the right place, and you need to be able to set expectations, and you have to have patience because you're dealing with so many also technological factors. Mm-hmm. So everything from the editing to the formatting to submitting files, publishing, distribution. You know, the size of your images need to be a certain DPI, and, you know, I mean, there's so many technical elements that go into the publishing process that folks think, well, once I've written the book, I'm done, I'm there, you know, this is great. But that's, you know, there's a lot more involved, and I do think that patience was, it's definitely, I could see that over over all the time we've worked together.
Yeah, because, you know, I have patience with a lot of things, but, you know, like, I had to make sure that, I mean, just the flow of things and just, you know, not wanting to give up, just like the things she said, I mean, pictures. I mean, so what? All the pictures are not the same size. Oh, who cares? No, yeah. It all has to be right. Listen, we have a caller. Hello?
Hi, Marilyn. It's Susiani. How you doing?
Hey, Susiani. How are you?
I tuned into the right show today, I'll tell you that.
You did? Are you writing a book, Susiani?
No, I have experience with this. I wrote a book, a little more than 2 decades ago, and more than one, but I wrote a novel. And it was back in the day. There was always vanity presses, and that's, you people are not using that terminology, but that's the difference between one route and the other that you were discussing, and you didn't use the word, but vanity press has, it has a negative connotation. It's like, oh, somebody wrote a book, and they think they're so good, so they paid to have it published, just so they could see their name in print, say, I wrote a book, whereas, so I have a million questions that I want to ask, because, but I have to give you my little background. So back when I wrote the book, and it was in the 80s, the route that you went was you subscribed to Writer's Digest, bought the magazine, and then you bought the big book every year, and you'd go through and all the hundreds of thousands, actually, of publishers, but you always had the big three, and which was Random House, it was Simon & Schuster, it was McGraw-Hill, I'm leaving one out. There was a, you know, it got less and less as big publishers, it was costing more, and we weren't dealing with the Kindle yet, and it wasn't that, okay, but you could not send a manuscript, and you still can't, Marilyn, so just so you understand that, okay, because people need to know this, you cannot just send your manuscript, or your first three chapters, and a summary to a publishing house. You will get it back in the same envelope you sent it, stamped. We do not accept unsolicited submissions. So the route you have to go is an agent. And that agent, again, the big agencies, and I can't think of the names, but you would know them if I said them, because they don't just deal with books. They deal with all kinds of media. You need to know somebody. You could send your manuscript to all the agents you want. You're going to get half of them back saying they didn't even open it, and they don't accept unsolicited, even agents at that time. So it was said that wasn't it Stephen Kuntz? And I could be getting mixed up because it could be somebody else. Not Stephen King, Kuntz. What was his, whatever, okay? He went, the publishing houses only promote their A-list. They do not promote their B-list books. So he was a new author, and you're not going to make the A-list. So he ended up with all these books, selling them out of the back of his station wagon, going from flea markets and going wherever. And that's how, and Stephen King has his story of all the rejections.
Everybody, you know what? Everybody has a story.
Right.
Sherry sent me an article to help inspire me, which it did, while I'm, you know, beginning my marketing process, about the Subway Man.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And that was a great story about this gentleman who, in New York, sells his books on the subway. That's how he sells his books. That's how he's making a living.
Yep. And that's the ultimate self-promotion.
Yeah, really. So anyway, Hold on one second.
So
I just want to
end up with an agent.
Okay, Susiani, hold on one second. I just want Sherry to comment about what you said. Hold on.
Okay, go ahead.
So, well, I would say yes. So if I can address the agent, yes. Number one, you cannot, if you're looking to be traditionally published, you cannot just mail off your manuscript. They will reject it, or they'll just throw it in the garbage. I mean, so it's a waste of time. Number one, I would recommend going to agentquery.com, where you can find a list of agents, and it tells you exactly what they're looking for, the genre they work in, the type of titles that they're looking for. You could also go, I recommend authors to go local. So start local. So if you're in the Triangle,
which is what I did. I went to a local, the only agent there was.
Well, not just an agent, but you can look at different publishers now, the smaller publishers, and I'm not talking about a Simon & Schuster or, Hachette or anything like that. Go and find a publisher, a small publisher that publishes in your genre, whatever that might be, fiction, nonfiction, or whatever they specialize in, and go to their website, and there'll be a section that says submissions, and they will tell you how they would like to receive new content, new manuscripts. And some only work with agents, and some now are not working with agents, and they'll actually accept. But mostly their first round is they want a query letter, so they want you to explain, okay, tell me a little bit about who you are,
right,
what the topic is of your book, tell me right about the book, and what are your plans, and what are you going to do to market this? You know, why should they invest in you? Why, you know, you've got this idea for a book. Do you have any chapters written? Is it already written? Do you have 3 chapters done? Do you have 6 chapters? What, you know, where in the stage is this, is your title? So, yes, absolutely, you cannot just mail out a manuscript. It doesn't work like that anymore.
Yes.
That's old school. Now, let me ask
okay,
you.
Okay, now, go ahead.
I want to ask you, what are you doing? You said you published your book 20 years ago. What are you doing now to market or reintroduce it?
No, I did not publish. I never published.
Oh, you never did?
No. But the agent that I had, she also had a publishing house. She had a press. Okay. And she was a con artist, and the FBI, she actually staged her own death in 9/11 to get out of going to prison because there was so many. She used to advertise in the Writer's Digest.
Mm-hmm.
But she happened to be on a street that I was walking on. She put her shingle out, and the day that she opened her office, I saw it. I'm like, oh, my God, a literary agent. And I walked in there, and she did this whole thing, oh, what a con artist, where bring me in what you have. So I brought her in a children's book I had written, and I brought her in the first 100 pages of the novel that I had already finished, but I only brought her that. And she did this whole thing where she's like, you know, I have so many manuscripts sitting here that I have to read, and I really, you know, I can't take on another. It was a con job, okay? And she's like, and then I'm leaving. And she goes, come back in here. Well, leave that with me, and if I get around to it. And then a few days later, she calls me up late at night. Oh, my God, where's the rest of the book? I can't believe you left me hanging. And she really made me feel good. I was with her for a year. She submitted my book, which was not a romance novel, okay? She had an offer from Harlequin. She had Zebra, and I forgot what that, there was one more, and they wanted me to take all the sex and all the crime out of the book, which would have took a 500-page book and made it about 25 pages. And they also said the heroine couldn't be divorced and she can't leave her kids, you know. And so I'm like, you're marketing it to the wrong people. It is not a romance novel. And to tell you the truth, it was ahead of its time because it was, I used to describe it as being, Cape Fear meets Peyton Place. Because back in the day, that was something relatable, right? But now I would say to you, okay, that the reason that it couldn't get published was because of the sex and the violence and the crime that was in it. But, okay, 50 Shades of Grey would not have been picked up by a publisher back
right
then either.
Right.
Okay. I still have the manuscript.
So
now,
you need to, are you
going to
do something with it, Susiani?
Well, now I missed my opportunity because I thought it was pie in the sky. Mm. I was with her for a year, then I took everything back. She also got a contract on my children's book, and it fell through. And then after that, I had it with her.
Are you going to self-publish it now? I mean, it's still not too late.
In 2000, I was contacted by a father and son who had the idea to print on demand when nobody was doing it. And he explained it to me, and they said, just like what you said, you know, this way you don't have to stock books and the expense of printing. Okay, it's all computerized, and as somebody orders, we print one. And then it would have been a 50-50 split with him and I on the, and it was a great deal. It was a great deal for somebody who would, but I said, people aren't going to have a handheld thing and download books, because he's also telling me about.
Well, you were ahead of your time, but then again, oh my goodness, they will.
I thought it sounded crazy, but he used to work for a publishing house.
Right.
And he saw, he knew what the buzz was about handheld Kindles, and he knew before it was happening.
So,
and he actually found a bookstore in Colorado. He had actually shown them my first three chapters.
Right.
And they wanted me to come and do a book signing and come in. But I would have had to pay for it, and I didn't right. have a pot to piss in or a window to throw it out, so I couldn't do it.
Suziani, hold on just a second. So what Suziani's talking about is really relevant for a lot of the conversation we're talking about because of Sherry's book and because of somebody like Sherry out here who can help guide you so you don't get, because, you know, there are those situations, and when you get excited, you know, with the opportunity of publishing and, mm-hmm. you know, fame, you know, we see a lot of people who are doing this today who are being very successful. And, you know, the thing is, a lot of people want to speak and make presentations, and a lot of people want to publish. And so yes. you see an opportunity and you want to grab it. But there are ways to do it, and that's why we're doing a series.
Okay, but I do have a bunch of questions.
Okay, so okay. but well, hold on a minute, though. Just let me finish this one thing. We are mm-hmm. doing a series of mm-hmm. shows, and Sherry's going to mm-hmm. be on again next week.
Oh, next week.
Next week.
I'll be back
and
next
then,
week.
Oh, right.
Yeah, so we're okay. going to touch upon all kinds of things that, you know,
we're going to go deeper into yes. formatting and editing yes. and the marketing and distribution and all of that.
Because it's very important,
yes, now,
so you don't get into it.
I want to ask you one
okay,
important
ask
question.
Okay, ask one, because I have somebody on the chat, Suziani, has a question too, and I want to answer that. So ask Sherry your question, because we're going to be out of
time.
Okay. Yeah.
So 5 years ago, I was approached and I illustrated children's books for this guy, five of them. And he had self-published one children's book before. And he was going to self-publish. Well, he didn't do it, but what I'm asking you is, everything you're talking about, does it also apply to children's books?
Absolutely. I mean, children's books, obviously you're printing in color, but you usually have less pages, so it's going to be not as expensive.
But I mean, these places that you're talking about, like Create Space.
You can
Space
go to Create Space
and Ingram.
In Ingram. As a children's book, I would recommend you're going to have to do an 8.5 by 8.5 if you want to do a square. You mm-hmm. can also do an 8 by 10. It really depends on the illustrations, but I would recommend doing an 8.5 by 8.5, and you can do it at paperback or hardcover.
And is there initial, do you need an amount of money up front to even do the Create Space or the Ingram?
You can do it for free through Create Space, but if you want distribution with Ingram Spark, it is, I think it's $49 to submit the distribution, and you do need to buy a print copy, so you're going to have to pay for your copy.
Yeah, but it's not that.
But it's not, yeah.
But that's not, it's about the cover, it's about getting the whole book.
Right, once you have your
right.
files ready, that's, you know, there's no additional fees.
I've had everything ready for 5 years.
Yep, then you can go, you set up an account, and it'll cost you $49 to submit it and distribute it.
Now, you don't need the same thing for an ebook as you would for a print, right?
Well, an ebook, you're going to need an EPUB file.
So it's going to be
a little different. So you're going to have to pay a little extra if you also have the ebook.
Now, my question for Marilyn.
Yes.
Is, so Marilyn, did you have like 1,000 books printed before you started making your appearances?
No.
How did this work?
No, it's I put it out there. I had people going to Amazon in just one afternoon and buying it right from there, buying the ebook, buying the paperback book, and then I bought books. I bought 50 of my own first because I had 22 men in my book and I needed to send them all a signed copy. So I bought them all a book, sent them all a book, sent the editor, sent the woman who did the cover, gave Sherry a book, and then I had some to sell. And then every time I go to a signing or a presentation that I'm doing or whatever event, I make sure that I have like 20 some odd books with me.
We used Create Space and Ingram Spark to publish Marilyn's book.
So your book is not going to be in the brick and mortar Amazons or
it's available. When you use distribution wise with Ingram, the book is available for purchase. So anytime Marilyn goes into a bookshop and schedules an event, that bookstore can order it.
Yes,
it's at the bookstore's discretion whether they'd like to carry a copy or not.
And it's on Ingram, So, yeah. But you as a person or any persons can go right to Amazon, could put in just one afternoon, and the book will come up and you can buy mm-hmm. it on, for as an ebook for Kindle, or you can buy it as a paperback. Mm-hmm. Same thing with Sherry's book.
Yep.
You know, Sherry's mm-hmm. book is also there. You can go into the books and you can buy hers the same way, and then it mm-hmm. comes to you. I mean, a lot of people, even friends of mine, bought it that way because they wanted mm-hmm. to be able to authentically, people wanted to be able to, they wanted to do it for me, but they also, then they can write a review.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And that was mm-hmm. important as well. In fact, one of my clients even put down in his review that he was a client of mine and he wanted to review this book so that it, you know, because people want to be authentic. And I certainly didn't mm-hmm. want anybody doing a review that wasn't going to be authentic. So, yeah, that's the process. But hold on, Susiani. April is on here, and she has a very good question. And she wants to know, can you publish on both Amazon and Lulu?
You can. What I recommend as far as a strategy, if you would like to use Lulu, if you want to be able to buy copies of your book, let's say you've done a nonfiction book, and a lot of times you've done a special edition or something that you want to sell separately, or if you're a speaker, I recommend using Lulu, because if you publish with CreateSpace, at the point in which it's ready for purchasing and you approve it, it will automatically be published to Amazon. If you publish through Lulu, you can have the same book that you publish through Lulu, but you make it private, so only you can purchase it, so you're not pushing it out to the world. So I would say, if you're going to publish, that's how I would use Lulu. And again, if you want to get the book into other retailers and have a return policy and make it available to Barnes & Noble and to your local indie bookstores and all those other, you know, retailers that are selling books, I would use CreateSpace to get to Amazon, and then use Ingram Spark so you have that return policy. And use Lulu. You could use Lulu, you know, because Lulu has got a better community as far as a social community for authors to connect with. So you could actually use Lulu and Ingram Spark as another option if you enjoy the Lulu experience. But I also
Important question about both Lulu, Ingram, and CreateSpace is: you, the author, do you get a discount? Do you get wholesale prices?
You do get wholesale pricing, yes. And you're going to pay you're going to pay the most with Ingram Spark and Lulu over Amazon. But yes, you get wholesale pricing.
And when she says Amazon, she's meaning CreateSpace.
CreateSpace, yes.
Yes. Yes, I know.
Because if you go to Amazon, and you buy your own book, you're buying it at
the retail
price.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But you buy it through CreateSpace.
Yourself. Correct. You log into your author account, and you can order it at a wholesale cost.
Right, but I had to buy it. CreateSpace was moving their warehouse, and
yes.
they could not. I, you know, figured I would get the, you know, I needed it for an event, so I went to CreateSpace, and they couldn't give it to me till after the event. So I had no choice but to go to Amazon and buy it through Amazon and pay the retail. Mm-hmm. But of course.
Okay, so Sherry, that's another question then. So Sherry, are Lulu, Ingram, and CreateSpace, are they print on demand? They're not stocking books.
They are print on, they're all three print on demand.
Son of a gun.
Yeah.
I could have gotten in on that.
Yes.
17 years ago.
But remember, when you go to Amazon, you know, you can buy, which I did. I bought books through Amazon Prime. So I was able to get it. I don't know how they do it, but I was able to get it in like 2 days, mm-hmm. which, you know, so you have that, because sometimes you don't know what you're going to sell. Maybe you already have some. So there are certain tricks, but that's what I have Sherry in my life for, and what I would suggest, you know, it not everybody might, you know, need all the degrees, but, you know, it's great to have a place like a Bible to go to
so
say, what's the question?
So is Sherry the equivalent of, in this, I don't want to call it a genre, in this space of this kind of publishing, are you the equivalent of an agent?
No, I'm not an agent. I'm a publishing architect. I mean, I'm an expert on the publishing. If you're looking for an agent, you know.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm like, do you kind of do...
I'm not an agent.
I'm confused what you do.
She could be an agent, but that's not what she does.
Yeah, I don't work directly with with the publishers to place books. I specialize in the independent publishing space as relative to books. I mean, I also publish magazine and podcasts, have radio program and whatnot. But I work with authors to help them map out their publishing and book marketing strategies. So if you need help and handholding from start to finish, I can work with you there. Or we can just sit down, do a consultation, and based on your needs and your content, we can figure out a plan and get yourself a path so you can actually go out there and do it yourself.
Okay. All right, Susiani, come next week because I know you have more questions, I'm sure your questions are the same as everybody else's questions. So,
and you know what? This was fascinating, and I got so much out of it.
Thank you. I love you. Thank you for being here. And everybody that's out there, I'm going to ask Sherry for a final word, but she will be here next week.
I will.
And the following week. So come back because we have just begun.
Scratch the surface to dig. Yes.
So go ahead, final words or have anything.
Well, I just say to authors out there, I hope you join us for the rest of the series here at the Breaking Free Show. And, you know, please go out and buy my book, Self-Publishing Fundamentals. And, you know, get in touch with me at publishingarchitect.com.
And so I love you all for being here. Thank you so much. I think it's very exciting. No, I know it's very exciting to be part of birthing, you know, people with a voice and having you go out there and share what you know and your message, because it's very, very important that we all do that. My book is also on Amazon, and I thank Sherry so much for helping me get it there, because on my own, I'm not sure if I would have. I needed the handholding. Mm-hmm. I don't think I would have done it, but now I'm working on my second one, too. So everyone, thank you for being here. I'm Nan as well. Well, thank you for being here. Thank you for having me here. And with that, we'll see you all next week. Have a wonderful week. Bye.
You're tuned to the Nissan Communications Network. If you tuned in too late, you can always watch each program in its entirety or download an MP3 audio file of it in the archives section on nissancommunications.com. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Twitter, and like us on Facebook. Sponsored by Atomos.com, makers of quality video recorders and converters, CarolinaApparel.com, and DeltaForce.net.